Well, hello everyone. Now, I wasn't planning on making another video about the heat pump, but you guys keep asking me if it still works. The answer is, of course it still works. So, it's running right now, we're going to have a look at it, and after that, I got to clear up some misconceptions that everybody keeps having about this thing. Let me show you one of my favorite things about the heat pump. See this right here, thermostat, with a thermometer in it? See, it says 72. It's 72 degrees in this room. This is a thermostat for the house. See what it's set on? 72. See what the actual temperature is? 72. Here in the dining room, once again, 72. It's a favorite thing about this. Every room in the house is 72 degrees. You set the thermostat at 72, every room is 72. The gas furnace in this house doesn't do that because the air comes out too hot and makes one room's hot and the other rooms are really cold. Then the thermostat gets fooled, thinks, oh, I should shut off. Then the rest of the rooms are cold and the hallway back there where the thermostat is warm. That's silly, isn't it? Heat pump doesn't do that. I do apologize for the lighting, but this is the control box, all still the same. Have the door open just so you guys can, well, you can barely see it, but yeah, here's the temperature controller. The voltage doubler's over on that side. That's just a contactor that tells the motor controller to start. And of course, the circuit breaker. And there was a concern that something, you know, might happen with those capacitors. Somebody might touch it and get the shock of their life, but hasn't happened because this just stays closed. There's the motor controller. And as you can see, there's no sort of hunting anymore. It just stays right at the frequency it's supposed to. And it can run like that all day long. And like I said, it keeps the temperature perfect. And here it is. It's still running outside. Here's the temperature of the air entering into the outdoor unit. So it's pretty warm today, but not warm enough to turn the heating off, as you can see. This is the temperature of the air coming out. So, yeah, it's pretty much running at minimum output right now. Keeping the house just at the right temperature and not working too hard. This is the temperature of the air coming out of the vent. As you can see, it's a little bit above 72, not much. But I told the temperature controller I wanted the heat pump to run at 25 Celsius, which is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's the reason why it does such a good job at keeping all the rooms at the same temperature, because the air comes out at the same temperature in all the rooms. There's not really hot air coming out of one vent, and really maybe a little bit not as hot air coming out of another. It all comes out at a nice even temperature, and it runs nice and long cycles. Well, sometimes it might even run all day, but it doesn't use very much electricity to do that, so it definitely is worth it to have the variable speed compressor. So as you can see, it's still running great. It's been about 3 years since I first put it in, and haven't really had any problems with it. Now, there are some issues, of course. I think the biggest issue would probably be when the compressor hits the resonant frequency, then it makes things buzz and shake, but not really that big of a deal. As you can tell from the video, still pretty quiet, especially inside the house. You can't really hear anything. Another issue is noise and interference. There's a little bit of interference. Some of the computers don't like it. The motor controller makes a little bit of noise, but nothing too bad, you know. But one of the biggest misconceptions, we have to address the misconceptions, like I said earlier. So the biggest misconception is that the motor controller actually doesn't increase frequency. There's people commenting and saying it won't help, it doesn't matter, because, you know, energy is just power and time together, so you'll just be using less power, but you'll be using it for a longer time, and it'll just be using the same amount of energy. That would be true if I were using an electric heater, but we're not. We're using a refrigeration cycle, a vapor compression cycle, let's get it precise. So this is the way it works. When a compressor is running, part of the power okay, goes towards compressing the refrigerant gas, what it's supposed to do. But then another part of the power just goes to moving the compressor's internal parts. And this is especially true with positive displacement compressors, which is pretty much what everybody has in their house. I don't know of anybody who has a centrifugal compressor in their air conditioner for their house. So anyways, as the compressor speed increases, that means a larger portion of that power goes towards moving around the compressor's internal parts. So if you're trying to make the compressor turn really fast, you're going to have to put a lot of power just into overcoming the inertia of the scrolls or the pistons inside the compressor. So it makes sense then, if we don't really need the full capacity of the air conditioner, heat pump, whatever, that we should slow it down so we're not throwing as much energy away just moving the compressor's internal parts around. Does that make sense? So with the motor controller, we slow it down, we slow the compressor down, should be specific, we slow the compressor down. When we don't need full capacity, when we don't need full output all the time, we slow it down so we don't spend as much energy just moving the compressor's internal parts around. Now, a lot of people are going to say, well, how do you know this actually saves on the bill? Well, I'm told by the man that pays the bill, it saves quite a bit. So, next misconception, we gotta move on. There's several. These are just comments I'm getting, by the way, from a lot of you guys. Another one is the, everyone says three-phase. I haven't got three-phase in my house, but the truth is I don't either. A lot of people actually think I have three-phase and I don't. That would be nice, but I don't. If you're living in the US or the UK, it doesn't matter. You have what I have. You have 240 volts AC single phase. So how does that work? The compressor I've got is 460 volts three phase. How does that work? How does that run? Thing is, I've got a voltage doubler circuit. Now, I will show you a diagram of that probably over there somewhere, and it's not hard to make. It doubles the voltage from 240 volts up to 480 volts and rectifies it. So it's a high bus voltage of 680 volts DC. Goes into the motor controller. The motor controller takes care of turning the DC into three phase. The temperature controller tells the motor controller what frequency to run the compressor at, and that's all there is to it, pretty much. So that brings me to my next point. What is actually happening? And some people are a little bit confused about this whole thing. It's a heat pump, it's an air conditioner, and it has a variable speed compressor. What's going on? So let's start off with the basics. It has a compressor, a condensing unit outside, and an evaporator inside. It doesn't have an expansion valve. It doesn't have a defrost controller. It doesn't have a dual fuel kit. It doesn't have any of the other sort of heat pump things that you'd expect. It has a reversing valve, and that's about it. Inside, it's got an evaporator and a fixed refrigerant metering device. So pretty much this is what happens. There's a temperature sensor, like a thermocouple, that's clamped onto the suction line outside at the condensing unit. Okay, and that goes into the temperature controller. You tell the temperature controller what you want it to do. So I set it to 25 Celsius for heating. That's 77 degrees Fahrenheit. So the temperature controller will either increase or decrease its command to the motor controller, depending on, say, if it's in heating and it gets colder, it'll increase its command. And if it's in heating and it gets, you know, warmer, it'll decrease its command. And it tells the motor controller that. Says, hey, you either need to speed up the compressor or slow it down. And there is a minimum and maximum frequency range for the compressor. So right now I've got it at 80 is maximum, and 80 hertz maximum, and 30 hertz is minimum. And then from there, the thermostat just tells the motor controller when to start and stop. And also the thermostat just tells the reversing valve what position to be in. Should I be heating or should I be cooling? And that's really all there is to it. Now, once it gets down below, like, say, 40 degrees Fahrenheit, we don't bother with defrosting or anything like that. That's a huge waste of energy. And like I said, there's no backup electric heaters. We just have a gas-burning furnace. And we just switch the thermostat over to emergency heat, and it just ignores the heat pump completely. And cooling, it's largely the same. You just flip the thermostat to cooling, and the temperature controller, you just set it what you want it, and say, probably set it for 15 degrees Celsius, and it runs and it does its thing. So, did you understand that, guys? Did that make any sense? It's just a normal heat pump without any of the controls in it. It just has a reversing valve, and that's all there is to it. And the variable speed compressor and the motor controller just takes care of the rest. Now, before I did this project, I did some research, and a lot of people said you probably wouldn't want to put a variable speed compressor in a household residential heat pump or air conditioner, because they said, well, it's not going to save that much money, and it won't work because of the oil return on the compressor, and the oil will be stuck in the evaporator. And even after I posted the video, a lot of people said that, but 3 years later, I really don't see any problems. Suppose maybe there is oil in the evaporator. I would never know. It seems to be working okay. With oil in the evaporator, you'd think it wouldn't transfer heat as well, but it really doesn't seem to have any problems heating or cooling. The performance is still the same, even 3 years later. And the people who made the compressor seem to think it's okay to run it in this sort of frequency range too. So I don't really see any issue if they don't really see any sort of issue. I was just thinking, guys, this is another thing I wanted to clear up. Yes, it is a reciprocating compressor, and yes, reciprocating compressors do work on motor controllers. So somebody was watching this video and said, are you sure that's not some sort of rotary compressor? And I know why they say that, because most of these variable speed units, like the new, you know, the little mini split things, they do actually have rotary compressors, but this is an old-fashioned reciprocating compressor. It is hermetically sealed, of course, but... And there was another thing, this was kind of funny, that somebody said you can't use a reciprocating compressor on a motor controller because when the piston comes back down, it'll cause regenerative braking, and then the motor controller will experience an overvoltage on the bus. And, well, don't really know what they're on about because it works. Okay, that's all I can say, it works. So I think the only issue really with the whole thing that's of real concern is somebody brought up that the power factor is probably going to be quite low with one of these setups. But of course there are ways to fix that, but that'll probably be another video because that's a pretty complex topic. Well guys, that's about it for this one. So there was going to be another video that I was going to do before this, but ran into technical difficulties. But hang in there, it's still coming out. It's not going to be about the heat pump. I thought it was pretty cool myself, but you'll just have to wait and see. So if you do have any questions about this video or any other videos, you can comment or message me. I am still reading. I've been busy, but I think I'm going to make some time to make some more videos. So I thank you for watching, and I will see you later.